Welcome to our deep dive today. And wow, your article on CD47, that's some really cool stuff about cancer immunotherapy.
Oh, absolutely cutting edge. Really fascinating.
It's like we're diving into this microscopic battleground.
Yeah, totally, like inside our bodies, right?
Yeah.
And it all boils down to how these tumor cells, they're sneaky, they evade, being destroyed.
Right, and how we can actually fight back, like manipulate those signals, the ones our cells use to chat.
Exactly.
So, okay, the article, it mentions this thing, CD47. For anyone just tuning in, like, what is that exactly?
Okay,
And
so
why should we even care? I mean, cancer seems to really love it.
it does. It does. CD47, think of it like a don't eat me signal
Okay.
that almost all our cells use. They're basically telling the immune system,
Yeah.
hey, I belong here. Like, just move along.
Right.
And the immune system, these Pac-Man-like cells, macrophages, they actually listen.
Oh, wow.
They're patrolling, looking for anything sus, anything dangerous.
Oh, so CD47 keeps them from, attacking the good guys.
Yeah, it's crucial for that, for preventing friendly fire, basically.
Right, like an internal passport,
Not
right?
exactly.
Safe and legal resident, good to go.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Cancer cells, they figure out how to use this to their
Oh,
advantage.
no.
They exploit it.
They do, the sneaky little.
Oh yeah, they start overproducing CD47. Imagine it's like a giant flashing billboard. Don't eat me.
Oh, wow.
It's a disguise, a really clever one. Lets them evade, the immune system security.
So how does this anti-CD47 therapy, this immunotherapy, how does that change things?
Well, this is where it gets cool. Scientists have developed antibodies, like one called MIAP301. What it does is it binds to CD47, blocks the signal.
Oh,
Like
interesting.
someone just confiscated that fake passport.
Uh-huh.
Suddenly, the macrophages, they see the tumor for what it is,
And then what?
a threat, and
Okay.
they gobble it up. Phagocytosis, it's called.
So it's like we're not just, marking the cancer cells. We're actually letting the immune system, empowering it to destroy them.
Exactly.
But here's what I thought was really interesting. It's not just the macrophages, right?
No.
Blocking CD47, it sets off this whole chain reaction.
It's huge. It's what makes this so promising.
Yeah.
So when that macrophage, it eats the cancer cell after the CD47's blocked,
Right.
it doesn't just, eat it quietly. It breaks it down, presents pieces of it, antigens, to other immune cells.
Oh, so it's like showing the rest of the immune system, hey, this is the bad guy.
Yeah, like dendritic cells. They're like the intelligence
Yeah,
officer.
dendritic cells, right? They show what to target.
Exactly. They take those tumor antigens, present them to T cells, which are like the special forces.
Okay, so it's like a multi-pronged attack.
Precisely.
We're not just sending in like the macrophages, we've got the elite forces ready to go.
It gets better. Remember how the macrophages, they engulf the cells?
Yeah.
Well, that process,
Yeah.
it also seems to boost the immune system's memory.
So it's not just about right now, it's about preventing it from coming back.
Exactly. That's the potential of anti-CD47 therapy. It's like this cascade,
Wow.
a symphony of immune activity all orchestrated
Cool.
to target and destroy those cancer cells. Yeah, symphony, it's pretty amazing, right?
And it's not just like a theory, right?
Right.
The article talked about MIAP301 and
Exact.
how it's had these incredible
It's
results.
showing real promise. Yeah, in preclinical studies, it's really shrunk tumors.
Yeah, like it wasn't just talking about the potential. It was like, hey, this is actually working.
It is. It
I mentioned leukemia, breast cancer.
yeah, even some solid tumors.
I know, those are supposed to be like really tough to treat.
They are. They're much more challenging.
Yeah.
The environment, it's just different compared to, blood cancers like leukemia.
Right.
But seeing a response, even in those cases,
Yeah.
that's a good sign, definitely.
Now, the article also mentioned this SIRPα. Is it SIRPα?
It's SIRPα. Yep, you got
Yeah.
it.
Okay. What is that? Like, what's its role?
So SIRPα, it's the receptor
Okay.
that CD47 actually binds to
Right.
on the macrophages.
Yeah.
Think of it like, lock and key.
Right.
CD47, it's the key. SIRPα, it's the lock.
Okay.
When they link up, that's the don't eat me signal.
Gotcha.
MIAP301, it basically jams the lock, prevents the signal.
Oh, so it's like cutting off the communication
Exact
between the
part.
cancer cell and the macrophage.
Yeah, like they're trying to send that don't eat me message, but it's blocked.
That makes sense. That makes a lot of sense.
Right.
But it almost seems too simple. Like, are there downsides, challenges?
Well, you see, CD47, it's not just on the bad guys.
Oh, right.
It's on healthy cells, too.
Okay.
So one of the biggest things is you know, making sure the immune system doesn't attack the good guys along with the bad guys.
Right. So it's like we're giving it this weapon, but it needs to aim it right.
Precisely.
Otherwise, it's just going to go haywire.
That's why researchers, they're working on more targeted antibodies, ones that really focus on the cancer cells.
Oh, that's good.
And try to spare the healthy ones as much as possible.
So it's all about balance, right?
Always. Effectiveness versus safety.
Yeah, I feel like we hear that a lot with cancer treatments.
Oh, absolutely. And another challenge is not all tumors, they don't all express CD47 the same way.
What do you mean?
Some, it's like they're covered, plastered with those don't eat me signs.
Right.
Others, not so much.
Oh, so some are like, come get me. And others are like, maybe not.
That's something like that, yeah. Which is why, you know, the article mentioned combining therapies.
Oh, right, like with chemo.
Exactly, chemo or even other immunotherapy.
Because this isn't going to work for every single person.
It's not a magic bullet, unfortunately.
What's the thinking behind that, combining them?
Well, the idea is you hit the cancer from all sides. Use different, you know, tools, different ways to cripple it. And that's where chemo, which, you know, people think it's this blunt instrument.
Yeah.
It can actually help. Because, it kills cancer cells, but it also can make them burst open.
Right.
And when that happens, what do you get? More of those antigens we talked about?
Oh, so it's like chemo softens it up.
Yeah, think of it that way.
And then the anti-CD47 swoops in and finishes the job.
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah.
And then you've got other immunotherapies like checkpoint inhibitors. You've probably heard of those.
I have, yeah. They're like releasing the brakes on the immune system.
Exactly.
So it can attack more.
Exactly. It's like giving it that extra boost.
It's amazing, though, how all these different treatments with their own like mechanisms, they can work together.
They can.
Like assembling a team of superheroes.
I like that analogy.
Each one has their own superpowers,
right?
But together they can take down, you know, the supervillain.
Just like with a superhero team.
Yeah.
Finding the right combination, that's key.
Exactly. And that makes me think about, you know, this whole idea of personalized treatment.
Right. Personalized medicine, tailoring it to the individual.
Because what works for one person, it might not work for another.
Exactly. Cancer's not one size fits all.
And we're learning so much about the immune system.
We are.
And how complex it is.
Right. It's not as simple as we once thought.
It feels like we're getting closer to that, to personalized treatment.
I think so, too.
It really is amazing, you know, to think about, like, not just treating cancer, but actually curing it.
Yeah, that's a powerful thought.
Because we figured out how to, like, use the body's own defenses.
And it's not just a pipe dream anymore.
Right.
The progress, even the last decade, from chemo to targeted therapies, and now this, it's huge.
It really is. You know, reading about this anti-CD47 therapy and all this personalized stuff, it makes me think about my friend. She's been battling breast cancer. It's been rough.
I can only imagine those stories. They remind us why we do this. You know, every new discovery, it's a step closer to a future where cancer isn't this scary, overwhelming thing.
Exactly. And it's not just about the cure, right? It's about, like, quality of life.
Absolutely.
Finding treatments that work, but they're not so hard on people so they can, you know, still live their lives.
And that's where personalized medicine comes in, right?
Yeah.
We're realizing cancer, it's not one size fits all.
Right.
Every tumor is different. The genes, the weaknesses, it's all different.
It's like what works for one person might not do a thing for another.
Exactly.
So we need to, like, tailor these treatments, right, instead of just this generic approach.
It's about precision, hitting the right targets.
Yeah, like smart missiles instead of cannonballs.
Exactly. And that's where understanding CD47, all these signals, it's crucial.
It's like we're learning their language, right? So we can outsmart them.
You got it. And it's not just one thing. It's the whole picture, the tumor, the tissues, the immune system, everything.
So about those personalized cocktails the article mentioned.
Yeah. Those.
What do you think? Like, is that really possible?
I think so. Imagine analyzing a tumor, finding its weaknesses. Is it CD47? Is it something else?
Right. Like figuring out its weak spot.
And then you design a treatment, combining therapies, each one targeting something specific.
Wow, like a team of specialists.
Exactly, each with their own expertise.
That's the future, right?
I think we're well on our way. The progress we're seeing, it's really remarkable.
It is. And to our listener who sent this in, thank you. This has been fascinating.
It really has.
We're on the edge of something big here, folks. A whole new era of cancer treatment.
It's an exciting time.
So keep those questions coming. Keep wondering what if, because that's how we get these amazing discoveries.
Couldn't agree more. Keep learning, keep exploring. Who knows what we'll uncover next?